Thank you, ma'am. Does anyone else wish to speak to the committee on this, this piece, this legislation? Give us your name and who you represent, please, ma'am.
My name is Kathleen Gary, and I'm a resident of DeKalb County, and I'm also one of the people in Georgia who has a microchip. And I've been talking to the different legislators and trying to get help in trying to outlaw this, the implants. I want to speak particularly on the medical issue of the microchip that she mentioned. And I just got a few things. Microchips, they infringe on issues that are fundamental to our very existence. That our rights to privacy, our rights to body integrity, the right to say no to foreign objects being put in our bodies, specifically the right to refuse microchips being put in our bodies by the government, whether or anyone else, the right not to be tortured in our homes by these microchips being scanned by electronic devices that's happening, and to activate these microchips, the right to work without being tortured by coworkers who are activating these microchips by using their cell phones and other electronic devices, the right to just live, work, worship, attend school, attend church services without being further tortured from these microchips. It's actually torture. It's just not just a little implant that you put in. You're actually tortured by these microchips. When they are scanned, they cause the body all kind of problems. Microchips are like little beepers. And just imagine, if you will, having a beeper in your rectum, a genital area, in the most sensitive area of your body, and your beeper number is displayed on billboards throughout the city, all done without your permission, with an award available for each caller. Hundreds of people calling you, blowing up your beeper, vibrating it in your flesh, invading your privacy rights to your own body. You're followed and tortured everywhere you go. You travel all over town trying to get somebody to help you get it out, and you, and instead, you feel the shocking pains from the tip of your spine to the bottom of your feet. It's like a grounding effect. Blurred vision, headaches, stomach pains, cramps, muscle spasm, uncontrolled blood pressure issues on 2 or 3 blood pressure pills, fatigue, stinging and burning skin, loss of concentration, ringing in your ears, heat sensation to the skin from the scanning devices, frictions of the vibrations that's going on with somebody calling and dialing, and this thing is working constantly in your flesh. It's torture every single day. And every time you try to find help, you go to doctors, and their hands are tied from giving you the proper medical treatment that you need and deserve.
Thank you, ma'am. I think we got a question from one of the committee members. Ms. Oliver, is it yours? Or no. Who was it? Someone on the end? Mr. Weldon?
Ma'am, did you say you have a microchip?
Yes, I do. And this microchip was put in my vaginal and rectum area. And I have been dealing with rape and sexual assault with them trying to take it out. When you try to make people accountable for what they have done to you, then they go to any extremes in trying to get it removed. And these are the issues that anyone, not just me, but any person who want to make people accountable for the implant that they put in them, they will deal with all kind of harassment, all kind of torture as a result of you speaking up.
Let me get him going. Do you want to ask me further? Anything further from any members of the committee? Ms. Garvey, is Ms. Garvey, is that right? Does that have a name right? Gary? Ms. Gary?
Yeah, Ms. Gary.
Excuse me. Okay. Sorry, Ms. Gary.
And that one other thing, you mentioned, gentlemen, you mentioned about the implant and being put in criminals. I feel like our right to, this deals with our right to our body integrity. This is a God-given right. When we are born, we are naked. We only have our bodies.
Let me ask, hold your comments, we'll get some questions to you.
Okay.
Mr. Maddox?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I guess I may have just missed it. I was just curious. You're saying this was an involuntary implant?
Yes. I am in the U.S. Appeal Court right now. This case has been going on for the last eight years, and we're trying to get some help in trying to get this outlawed and get some justice in that. I feel like Senate Bill 235 is on the right side of justice. This is an issue that is ongoing.
Let me ask you, hold your comments. We'll get the questions done.
Okay.
Anything further, Mr. Maddox?
That's all.
All right. Anything further from the committee? Let me ask Ms. Gary this. Who implanted this in you?
I feel like mine
You don't know who did it?
Yes. I'm one of the federal government research with this microchip.
And who in the federal government is implanting
this? This is the Department of Defense.
All right.
And this is the court case that is pending before the U.S. Appeal Court.
All right. Thank you, ma'am. Anyone else wish to address the committee that hasn't had a chance to speak? If not, we will close off public input. Yes, ma'am. You have to come around and let you take a seat here.
I'm Martine Burt, Alpharetta, Georgia. I have several people from an organization up there that's standing here. They might like to raise their hands that are opposed to it.
Put your hand. Put the mic down where they can hear you a little better now.
I said that there's several other people that are with me here today that might like to raise their hands that are opposed to